Hi guys, Kevin here. Welcome back to another car build. Leading up to Christmas, we're on to number 15 now. Absolutely crazy that we've made it this far. Last episode we made this. It's just pulled up right now. Nissan GTR, very nice car. It's S2 class. Obviously, it's a very powerful car, but it's running under 600 brake, which is wicked. So, very nice car. So check that out if you haven't. Also on this video, but in the comments below. Okay, there's someone going crazy in this lobby. But in the comments below, make sure you write a comment saying what car you want to see next episode. Sorry that I can't fit you all in. There's loads of you supporting this series, and I really appreciate it. But I do apologise, I can't fit every single car that everyone comments in, basically. I go for the highest voted comments, so if you do see a comment that you do like the look of, just thumbs it up. And the most thumbs up comment will get chosen, so that is the way I am doing this. So let's get on to the next car. The comment was by Peter Bergquist. Sorry if I said your name wrong. Black Mazda MX-5 slammed with retro rims. Okay, so this is gonna be a personal favourite of mine. I really do like the MX-5 Miata. Hopefully, it looks pretty nice on some retro rims. That'd be quite cool. But let's go grab the car. Okay, there it is, Mazda MX-5 Miata. There is also the new version of the MX-5, but I'm going with the old school version. I really prefer it, and I prefer the looks of it as well, so that's a no-brainer there. Got told to make the MX-5 black, so let's go into the colours, make it black. We need some nice retro rims on this, but that's about all I got told to do, so everything else is up to me, I guess. So, yeah. Got a good feeling about this build. Obviously, it's a very, very, very short wheel-based car. That is one thing I will stress across. You're not going to get this 100% stable. But in terms of this car, it's quite known for drifting in real life, like a start-off drift car, etc.
Hey, how's it going? What can I do to help
but
you?
But yeah, let's get going. I was trying to think of a word then, but it's not coming into my head. I'm not very good with language, like, what is English? English, what is this? Okay, so we could four rotor it, but I don't think so. I'm going to stick with a stock engine. Drivetrain, everything is fine in the... Okay, aspiration. Should we turbo it? It'll push up to 156 horsepower, which isn't that much more, to be fair. So let's slap on the turbo. And let's come out of there. Aero. Okay, there was no requirements about aero, so I'm gonna go with the first bumper here. Yeah, the first bumper. I really like that lip. It's got a nice clean feel to it, especially when I'm slamming this car. That lip's gonna make it look a lot lower than it actually is. Well, I kind of like that. No, I don't know. I prefer the stock wing here. I can't move my camera. Sometimes my controller works, sometimes it doesn't. So I can't move my camera to see better angles of this, but... Yeah, should we stick with the stock? I kind of like the exhaust on that one. The exhaust is smaller, and I prefer smaller exhaust. I don't know why. Pretty weird thing. But let's just jump in. I can't move the camera, but we might be able to see it from a different angle if we change right now. Nope. Okay, yeah, that looks right. It looks pretty smooth, which is good. Okay, side skirt. Should we go with the racing beat? Should we do it? I kind of like the seals on that one though. Like, if you look at the edges, yeah, I'm getting the first one. The Garage Rary. Ooh, what a name. Ooh. So onto the bonnet. Let's stick with a stock bonnet here. Makes it look a little bit cleaner. Seeing as we're going for the slant, look. Tires, we're going to stick stock, seeing as there's not a lot of power in this car. Tire width, okay, they're very low. Should go 215s on the front, and on the rears we can go... Donnie, let's go 245s on the rear. What's the next size up on this? 235s. Let's stick how that is. 215s and 245s. Okay, some retro rims. See, like, they're retro. I do like those, though. And they really suit this Miata, to be fair. All of them. Okay. Them. I'm going in with these. I never really put them on a car, so the only car they really suit is an MX-5. I don't really like that many spoked rims. Like, four spoke and below, they're not my cup of tea, but they do suit this car, I'm not going to lie. And it's probably the only car I would use these on. So let's do that. Slap these on. 16-inch on there. I suppose they do look a little bit retro, but I don't think they're that retro. So onto the drivetrain. Everything in drivetrain will be braced. So just go through and just put everything on brace. I really like the dish on those wheels. Some deep dish. God dish. Haha. All my old subscribers know what that is. God dish. Ooh. The catchphrase. That used to pop out every single video. Ah, where has it gone? Where has it gone? And let's slap race brakes on here. I thought I was inside race brakes then. I was moving all the way to the right to kind of upgrade it. But I was on weight reduction as though it would. Okay, race suspension as well. That makes it look delicious. I'm tempted to make those rims black. I'm tempted. We can have a look, see what it looks like, or we can make them a different color, maybe. That could look quite cool. So everything in here is probably going to be raised to. We're going to roll cage it. Weight reduction. I don't know what weight this has already. So okay, only 1,100 kilos. 900 kilos. Sorry. Okay, that looks very sweet. I'm not going to change the color of those wheels. Actually, I'm going to stick how they are. That looks wicked from that angle. It looks like a proper scene car. Like, if you go to a car meet, you'll probably see an MX-5 that looks just like that, really. So let's slap some power into this. 900 kilograms, this car. Should we all out this engine? Should we just go all out? Why not? I think it's going to push us to about 300, about, hopefully. So, yeah, let's do it. Why not? Why not? 206 already. Maybe it'll push us a little bit further then. 228. I don't know. It'll probably be on the boundary, to be fair. Yeah, I was just checking I put that on. That was really weird. 312. Okay, camshafts really helped there. Should we just go all out? Should we just keep going? Why not? We're going to have the power. The power. And we're going to have to try and tune for stability, I guess. Seeing as we're going to have a lot of power, it's going to be a little bit hard to control. 399 horsepower so far. I'm tempted not to upgrade to turbo because that's going to push it really far. I think it's going to push it that little bit too far. So let's do that. 427 horsepower there. And just slap on the race flywheel just to lose that little bit of weight. 4 kilograms. Yeah. let's see what the turbo does push it up. 469, which isn't too bad. We're just going to slap on the sport turbo there. Let's not go all out. Let's go kind of all out. Just semi all out. So yeah, that is a lot of power for this car, to be fair. I didn't really plan of doing that much power. Kind of wanted to make it feel quite stocky, but I guess I kind of lost that now. yeah, let's get out into free roam then. I'm not changing the color of those rims anymore. They've really grown on me. I wish you could adjust OSFET. I really just said OSFET. Mate, I'm committing suicide. Bye. Oh my god. I wish you could adjust offset, man. The one thing about this game, they could make it so simple. Just offset, please. So yeah, we're into free roam. We're in some random area. I went on a drive yesterday. But let's teleport over here to the industrial area. Let's get this sliding around the industrial. We don't want no traffic messing with us. So let's put this around here. And we're teleporting over there. So 5 million total winnings I've had on this game. I think that takes into you know, like the Forza rewards you get? I think that takes that into it as well. I think that's what I was trying to say. Oh, yeah. Should we spin? Why not? A car build spin. We're going to get the best car ever. Watch this. Oh, I thought we was going to get a Skyline then. Renault Megane RS250. Not bad. It's only 29,000 credits, so that's terrible. What are you going to get this time? 12,100 credits. So I'm not really the best there, to be fair. So let's spin this back around. Wow, this car looks so small. Look how small it looks. Oh, cute. Okay, gearing's got to go a lot longer. Oh my god. Gearing has got to go very longer. I feel like it's got the power though. I feel like it's gotten a bit too much power, to be fair, but we're going to tune this up. This Miata looking absolutely gorgeous. I'd love to own a Miata in real life. It's one of those cars that I want to experience. Just to drive a slammed Miata around. That would just be absolutely insane. Okay, this, no, I wanted to make it a little bit longer. So let's just go a tiny bit longer. I don't think it needed to go very far. Let's put a tiny bit of camber on this as well. Cars to 5.5, anti-roll bars. That's fine, let's bring up the rear a tiny smidge. Spring's pretty soft, to be fair. So I'm going to take this up. I like my cars a lot stiffer, so you can make it softer if you really want to, if you use body weight to initiate your drifts. Ride height all the way to the bottom. Damping looks pretty good as standard. Bump stiffness can come down a tiny smidge. Aero braking and a differential. 100% and 100%. We want to spin those tyres up. We want to do that. So yeah, let's try and get this slide in now. Okay, there's a lot of wheel spin then pulling away. Okay, it feels like it has a lot of power. That's probably the widest I've ever been on that corner. Okay, I wanted it. Transition was a little bit too snappy then, so we've got to try and slow that down. Oh god. I'm feeling like the gearing's got to go back to where it was. I've made it so much longer. Wow, but sorry, that was my fault. I just forgot to hold the wheel. I was just like, yep, just let it do its own thing. Yeah, that felt pretty weird. But obviously, this car is very short wheelbase, so it's not going to be the most stable tune ever. But I think we're going to have to grip this up a tiny bit. I'm going to start that by decreasing tire pressures. I think that's where we're going to start this. I think the front is fine in terms of tire pressure, but let's lower this right down and see if that actually makes a difference or not. The gearing could go shorter, just that little bit to back to where it was, 3.35, I think that was where it was. Let's just make that slight change. See if these tire pressures actually aid us here. Pulling away, they definitely do. We spun up there last time, so that really helped. Oh my god, that's close. Okay, transitions felt really slower, which is good. Especially for a car like this. Obviously, they're going to be snappy. Oh, wow. Snappy like that. Damn, son. I think camber's got to come down. It's far too sharp. We need to get some more tyre. Some more tyre on the ground. That felt nice through there, though. Held some nice angle. I'm going to lower the camber a little bit in the front and a little bit in the rear. Oh, what have I done? I've just had a right absolute nightmare. So let's just... What? Okay, let's do this. Sorry, I just had to check my phone. I thought someone... I'm expecting a text, but it wasn't the one I was expecting. But there we go. Okay, camber, going to lower it in the front just a smidge, 0.2. And in the rear, I'm going to go right down to like 0.6. Let's try that. I just feel like I need to stabilize this car. Alright, let's try. Okay, that felt stable. That felt quite stable there. Okay, That felt very nice there. It's doing alright on the transitions this time as well. One thing I will say about this car, be delicate on the throttle. Do not floor it. Even though I am flooring it, but when you're getting used to this car, do not floor it. Like, obviously when you're used to it, you can do whatever you want, but when you're first starting with it, be delicate on the throttle. It's a short wheelbase car. You won't be accustomed to it as soon as you kind of choose it. So yeah, look at that angle it can hold. That's quite nice. Very stable for a very short wheelbase car. Look at that. That was madness. Oh, I love that transition. That's the benefit of having a snappy short wheelbase car. In transitions when you're in trouble, I thought I went in with a bit too much angle and it just snapped back the other way. Perfect. Love it. Okay, let's give it another run. I've got a feeling this car is feeling quite nice, to be fair. I'm trying to think of a way to change it a little bit, but don't change something that don't need fixing, huh? You can go big with the transitions in this car. That's one thing I will say, you can go big. Once you're like 90 degrees facing that way, it just snaps back the other way. It's crazy! I think blowing that camber has really helped this car, because I think we just got a little bit too much power for this car, to be fair. That's one thing about this build. I think I just went a little bit too much power. But you know, you've got to have fun in these, making different cars. It's below 600 horsepower. It's a short wheelbase car, and it's a very light car, so you're obviously going to get a lot of wheel spin. So the camber has to be quite low. In terms of controlling and getting nice stability for like tandems, etc., you want that camber to be low. But if you're just like drifting around the map or something, you might want that camber to be pretty high, to be fair. Oh my god, I just wasn't concentrating one little bit. But if you're going from like very long corners, just drifting around the map, like different corners and stuff. But if you're doing like section work like this, low camber will work for you in this car. But if you do want a little bit more tire spin in this, which I don't think you will need, to be fair, seeing as I'm struggling in this car for tire spin. But in terms of, we have a lot of tire spin. It's got stability as well. That's one thing about this car. It's got quite a lot of stability for such a very short wheelbase car. It has a lot of stability, so I like that. Yeah, I'm starting to get used to the car now, which is a good thing. Once you start getting used to cars, you can start pulling off a little bit more angle, etc. But that will come as you get used to it. But yeah, that car feels very nice. It's got the power to pull out when you need to. That's what she said. But yeah, pretty nice car. Don't see the point of changing something that is working. So I'm going to stick with that tune. And yeah, I'm going to upload that onto the storefront for you guys to download if you don't want to copy down the tune from the video. So if you don't want to adjust the tune to your needs, you can just go on here, download the tune, and it'll be there, but it will be locked. Unfortunately, you can't unlock it in terms of tunes, but I'll put this up, Drift and Best for Handling. Just go on the storefront, just type in my name, my gamer tag, which is Kevin Toll, the same as my YouTube, and you'll be able to find that. So yeah, pretty sweet car. We'll be pulling this out in lobbies in the future. So if you want to join my open lobbies, follow me on Twitch, which is in the description below. I stream all my open lobbies on there. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll see you guys next time.